Hi, welcome to Read Tech. I'm Reggie, and today I'm going to talk about running Docker containers on my trusty Raspberry Pi 4. The Raspberry Pi 4 is a surprisingly powerful little device, completely capable of running several containers at the same time. And today it is going to serve as our container host. The container host is logically the device or machine that is actually running or executing the containers. Containers are a super easy way to install and run services without modifying the configuration of the host machine. If you've ever done any sort of miscellaneous application or program installations, especially not using a package management system, but even sometimes using a package management system, removing those applications is sometimes very difficult. And containers are a very easy way of, you know, installing these applications or services, running them, and when you're done with them, you're basically going to just remove them or stop them. And your host system is completely clean. It's a fantastic thing. And so for this demonstration, we're going to run a very simple Apache web server. And when we're done, we'll remove it. So the first thing that you need is you need to install Docker. So I've already installed Docker. We can look here and see that it is version 20.10.2. So we're good to go there. So the Apache container is httpd. So we'll enter docker pull httpd. And that's basically going to grab the latest httpd image from Docker Hub, as that is completing. We now have an image. So if we look at docker images-a, you'll see that in our repository now, we have the httpd image, the tag is latest, so it's the newest image, the image ID, and how long ago it was actually created on Docker Hub, along with the size. So in order to, at this point, we don't have a container, we just have the image. So we're going to run that image, and we're going to give it a name, Apache httpd, and we are going to forward port 888 to the container's port 80. So inside of the container, the httpd application is going to be running, and it is going to bind itself to port 80, but only from inside of the container itself. So without this command, we would not be able to attach to the running httpd server, you know, without mapping this port. So that's why we're doing it. And then finally, we specify the actual image that we want to run. So we'll do httpd latest. All right. So that actually should have started our container. We can do docker ps to see that it is indeed running. So we have the image that it came from, as we specified. You actually have the command that was executed inside of the container, which is the default, that it was created 12 seconds ago, only up for 10 seconds, and that we have mapped port 8888 to port 80 inside using the with the TCP protocol, and the name of the actual container is Apache HTTPD. Something that you'll see in Linux often is a binding to port or to IP address 0.0.0.0. And basically what that means is listen on any IP address that is actually up, or any interface that is up on the machine. So if I had four different network interfaces, every single IP address associated with those network interfaces would actually map port 8888 to port 80. Just something I think you may think is helpful if you didn't know that before. So our web server is running. So what I'm going to do is go to a browser, I'm going to enter the IP address, one of the IP addresses of the Raspberry Pi, which is 192.168.1.193. And again, port 8888. And then we have, you know, the basically it's a live message, it's working. So that is basically the super bare bones way of getting an HTTP server working. Some other things that you would potentially want to do if you actually wanted to use this this web server for, you know, any specific usage, you would probably want to map a local directory into the default HTML directory inside of the container. That way you could, on the host, container host, actually add content to be served by the web server without actually going into the web server. It also allows you to have that data persist. So for example, if a new version of Apache HTTPD came out that maybe had a bug fix or something like that, you could, if you've mapped a local directory into the container, you can basically kill the container, update the image, build a new container, and run with that same mapped directory. And now your web server is back up with your existing content and everything is patched. It's really nice, and it's very, very smooth. So I mentioned that we would actually kill this container and remove it. So let's go ahead and do that. So let's do Docker PS. We see that it's still running. So we'll do a Docker stop Apache-HTTPD. And that will stop the container. Then we can do a Docker remove, and I usually use the ID for this, and that should actually have removed the container. And we can run Docker with this command line, status exited, to make sure that we don't actually have any containers lingering. So that removed the container. Now we need to look at the image. So if we do Docker images-a, we'll see that we still have the HTTPD image there that could be used to create more containers. So let's say we want to get rid of that also. So we can just do a Docker RMI HTTPD for remove image, and it blows away the image from our container host. So we can go back, do images, and now we see that the image is completely gone. And we can also go back over here and try to attach to the server, and the server is now gone. So that's basically it. Again, this is a great way of running applications without messing up your host system. And when you're done with it, you just remove it and you're good to go. If this is interesting, leave a comment. If there's anything else about Docker that you'd like to explore, I may do another video where I use Docker Compose, which is a more elegant way of configuring and running Docker containers. If there's interest in that, let me know. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. And if you're interested in this type of content, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Thanks a lot for watching, and have a great day.